Well, out fixing field tie today with the cutest little baby backhoe you've ever seen in your life. I was hoping to go over and get some outboard plowing done today at the other new field I got. It's a hay field I got to get turned under, but Mother Nature kind of shut me down on that last night, so I'm doing this instead. Naturally, it's got to be cold and windy after being a nice 75 degrees for the last, since Monday. Actually, I guess since Sunday. That global warming, man, shit'll get you. I brought everything I need to fix this except the tile because I have no clue what's down there. Could be 4, could be 6, could be 5. For all I know, it could be a 36-inch main. I just gotta remember where it is. Actually, there's 2 holes down here. I found the big one, and there's another one supposed to be, said like 20 yards from it around here somewhere. Oop, there it is. Now there's that one. And there's that. That's gotta be it. So I actually don't. And it would make sense that it goes in. It doesn't go straight through the field and come at an angle because everything drains down here to this wet hole. Gotta be that little one. Yeah, we're gonna go with it. So now I gotta. That's definitely a tile hole. And he said it was that way, so ain't on the property line, so it's got to be that little hole right there, but we're going to work on this big one first. My original intent was I was just going to flag this thing and come back this summer and fix it when it was drier out. And then I saw how big it was. It's like, I probably ought to get that fixed before I drop an axle in it. That's hard. Wow, that's really hard. And I'm not so sure this field's actually that hard, because we didn't get rain for almost 2 months, and we didn't start getting rain till about a week ago. Well, actually, it would have been a week ago. Yeah, about a week ago tomorrow, actually. So it was last Saturday we got our first rain. And I don't know if the ground's hard or if it was just that dry that the water hadn't permeated it enough. Fill all the pore space back up yet and loosen it back up. Or if it's a combination of both. Because I do believe this field's also been no-till for the last 4 years. And in this area, with the ground we got, you can get by with no-tilling. If you want to plant early, you have to do something to work it, disc it, chisel it, run a VT tool over it, something, just to break the ground up and get it to dry out and warm up. But if you plant later, especially most guys that do no-till beans, which you don't plant till end of May anyway. I gotta hit it. You can get away with no-tilling like that, but if you do it for a bunch of years in a row like that, I don't care what anybody says, this ground starts to get hard. So alright, I'm going to finish getting this dug out, and I'll bring you guys back when we get to that point. Alright, I've fixed a lot of tile in my day, but this one takes the cake. So I started digging the hole, and I get to right here, and I start finding a bunch of freaking rocks. And there's still rocks down there. That pile's full of rocks, that pile's full of rocks, them two piles are full of rocks. Alright. But I finally found the end of the tile. Logic would tell you. Other end of the tile's right there. It ain't right there. And then, to make things weirder, I stuck the shovel handle in there to see which direction the tile was running so that I could figure out where I needed to keep digging over there. Well, I stuck the shovel in a little further. The tile stops. So I honestly have no clue what to do at this point, except keep. I don't even know. Just keep on digging until I figure something out. Alright, well, I'm officially at a loss. It clearly don't end there. Or it clearly doesn't go there. And I found out, I dug back this way to see what was going on, and it actually doesn't end, it's turning. So, I honestly, this is a new one for me. But the only thing I can figure, if it's going that way, there's got to be a lower spot over there. And apparently they didn't feel like tiling through that rise right, because there's a rise in between this low spot and that low spot. The only thing I could figure is they didn't feel like tiling between there, so they brought this tile over, stubbed it off, and threw all them rocks in here to create kind of like a catch basin. I don't know how else to explain all them freaking rocks, because it ain't natural, at least in this area, to find a whole bunch of rocks that big, that deep in one spot. So, I talked to the landlord, because he came down here to see how I was making out. And he saw what was going on, and he was just as confused as I was. And I think what's gonna go on, since I can't find the other side of that stinking tile. But since I can't find the other side of that stinking tile, is all I can do is get, you know, 6 foot chunk of corrugated or perforated field tile to run out here with an end cap and stub it off. Throw some rocks back in like they had it. Because, clearly there ain't no tile over there, otherwise I'd have found it by now, because that last chunk was right there, and you don't go 7 feet without any tile. There wasn't even any chunks. So, I guess. Well, I got everything dug out and ready to go back together, so at least I think I did. Probably a good thing I didn't bring any tile with me, because it turns out there's two separate tile lines in there, and they're two different sizes. One's a 4 and one's a 6. So we had some 6 at the house, and I went out to my old boss's place because he sells field tile, and he gave me that chunk and an end cap. So. Now the only downside is, I'm pretty sure the 6-inch tile is plugged. I think they let it go too long without getting it fixed, and I'm pretty sure it's plugged. So, really all I'm probably going to be doing is putting a band-aid on a gunshot wound, but short of digging up the whole tile, there's really no way to fix it other than put in a new tile. And it probably would have made it if there was only one break. But there was two breaks about 50 feet from each other, because I actually turned out there was 3 holes. There was that one, the first one I dug, and then there was 2 more down here further. And they were close enough together that the last one was feeding off the first one. And it plugged up at the second break. So I think it probably could have handled it if it only had to suck dirt from one, but having to suck it from 2 pretty much did it in. So, never did find the other side of that one tile. So Lord knows what the heck's going on there. I'm thinking my previous assumption was right. Coming. There it goes. Thinking my previous assumption was right, and they made that a sump, and that's why all them rocks were in there. Because I can't think of any other explanation as to why there wouldn't be another, or that tile wouldn't have went all the way through. And since the one further down from it opens up to a 6-inch. I got a feeling that's what's going on. And we're just gonna pull this down there. Damn it. This weather kind of sucks. It's right on the verge of being too warm for a Carhartt, but it's too cold for just a flannel, so you kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place. It's really bad when I was shoveling. Stay on there. Damn it, it's gonna fall. There it goes. So, fix the big hole first. This field will be ready to plow after this, but he's got to get that brush pile burnt. He's going to get that done as soon as he can, but I don't doubt I'll get out here this weekend. It'll probably be next weekend, hopefully. But I got at least one more field to get done, hopefully two. I'm waiting on the landlord to call me back, see what he wants to do, but. Alright, now I'll show you how to fix this tile. I already dug back till I found an intact stub off the old tile and dug around it with a garden spade. Now we're gonna take a piece of 4-inch. Like so. And because normally, if any of you that put a tile in, there's a coupler that slides in here and locks into the ribs if you need to put two pieces of tile together. And if you absolutely have to, you can use them on clay. But what we found back when I was still working at a farm in town here, where I spent a lot of time fixing tile during the summer. If you use that style coupler going from plastic to clay, it'll still try to suck dirt past the coupler. So what we always did was took some of the plastic and made our own coupler. Like so. And then you open it up. And snap it over like that. One more. Come on. Here we go. And then you make sure you put this gap on the bottom. Like so. And then take a piece of the 6-inch. You'd think as much clay tile's left around, the guys are still fixing. Somebody somewhere, come on, would make a coupler for going from plastic to clay, but nobody does. to that. Then here I'm using landscape fabric. What actually works best for this is tar shingles. But you get yourself a piece of fabric, shingles, whatever you got. Whatever you got handy anyway. This part's why shingles are easier, because they're easier to wiggle up in there. Dadgummit. Alright. Lay flat. But you take a shingle or landscape fabric, whatever you got. You can go around like that. I'm just gonna get one more piece here, because that's part of the problem is that tile is crushed a little bit and it's oval, and that makes doing this a little harder. Another thing that helps here is if you got two people. But go like that, and then that, in theory, is going to keep it from sucking dirt. Then you make sure you backfill it by hand a little bit. But yeah, that's basically how you kind of hillbilly fix clay tile. Now, originally, my plan was to throw some stone back in there and do like what they did, but this tile is actually made for going into clay. It's got a small slot, so I think I'm just going to cover it up and call it good. Otherwise, it'd be kind of redundant. I just hope I got enough dirt to fill the hole back in all the way. Give this little tractor one thing. For what it is, it'll push about like a bulldozer. For just having turf tires on it and that poor little guy's only 18 horse. Actually, I don't think I ever said this is a Ford 1210. If I remember right, Granddad bought this thing in 81, I want to say, for a contracting business. And it actually came from the Oliver dealer in town, because for a short time, after White took his dealership away, he carried Ford. But there wasn't anybody in our town used Ford, so he couldn't really make a go of it. He just decided it was time to quit. It's only got 264 original hours on it. So the thing ain't even hardly broke in. At least I think it does. I don't think it's rolled over once yet. But even if that's the case, that means it's only got 1,264 hours on it, which still ain't squat.